Okay, this is sample problem 15.12. Hydrogen sulfide, which is H2S, is a contaminant commonly found in natural gas. It is removed by reaction with oxygen to produce elemental sulfur. The reaction is 2H2S gas plus O2 gas forms 2S solid plus 2H2O gas. For each of the following scenarios, determine whether the equilibrium will shift to the right, shift to the left, or neither. A, addition of O2 gas. B, removal of H2 gas. C, removal of H2O gas. And D, addition of S. Okay? Now, here's the idea. This is Le Chatelier's principle. This example is, as is, are the next two. The issue here is changing concentrations of a system in a system that's already equilibrium. Remember, Le Chatelier's principle says that if the system is at equilibrium and then you make a shift to it, the system will adjust itself to come back to equilibrium, essentially to minimize the change that you made. Okay? So, here's how we could go about this. I'm going to write the equation down. And this one here, we need to be a little bit careful because there is a solid. Now, if we're talking about equilibrium, we might be talking about the equilibrium constant. So I'll use Kp since we've got gases. Kp would be the pressure of H2O squared divided by the pressure of H2 squared divided by the pressure of O2. Notice I did not include the sulfur, and the reason I didn't include the sulfur is it's a solid. Remember, solids and liquids don't get included. Okay. So let's take a look at part A. In A, we're going to add O2. So imagine it's like this. You're at equilibrium, and you've got some amount of H2 and some amount of O2. And some amount of H2O. And then you're going to add some. So in part A, we're going to add O2. What you would do mathematically is you would now say we've added some O2. So Q would be that original amount of H2O that we had, because we haven't changed that, divided by the original amount of H2 that we had. We haven't changed that. But now, that would be times the pressure that we originally had for O2 plus some additional O2, some extra O2, right? Look what happens in the denominator. This right here is larger than it is here, right? So that means that Q is going to have a larger denominator, so that means the value of Q will be smaller than Kp. Right? Check that out. Just put a number in. Put in 1, 1, and 1, so that's 1, right? And then put 1, 1, and then 1 plus 1, which is 2. That would be 1 over 2. That's a half. So Q would be less than K. And what did we say about the case where K was less than Q? Q was less than K. If Q is less than K, the reaction goes that way. And the way we would say that is that it shifts to the right. Okay? So what I'm doing is I'm saying I'm going to add O2, so it's going to be bigger. If O2 is bigger, that means the ratio in Q would be smaller than it is for K. So Q is less than K, the reaction shifts to the right. Let's try B. Get rid of some of this. In part B, we're going to remove some H2S. Okay? I'm sorry, we're going to remove some H2S. I'm sorry. This is H2S, not H2. That doesn't change the problem any. There we go. It's H2S. Okay. We're going to remove H2S. So now, let's do a new queue. Okay. So we have the expression for KP. It's right here. And let me actually get rid of some of these checks, just so it's not so busy there. Okay, now let's do Q. Well, we're not changing water, so that's going to be the same. But we're changing H2S, we're removing some. And then we're not changing oxygen. Okay. So what I did was I wrote a minus here, meaning that this is going to go down by some amount. So if that goes down by some amount, what happens to the ratio, right? If you make this number here smaller because you're taking some of it away, that means the denominator itself is going to be smaller. And if the denominator gets smaller, you're dividing by a smaller number. So that means it goes up. The ratio goes up. So that means that Q is now greater than K. If Q is greater than K, the reaction goes that way. That's why it was so essential that we learn that, right? So that means it shifts to the left. Now, when we say shifts to the left, what we mean is if you take some H2S out, the reaction will run in the reverse direction and it will form more H2S and it will also form more O2. Okay? So that's part B. Now let's move on to part C. In part C, it says we're going to remove H2O gas. So let's do it this way. Pressure of water is going to go down by some, right? But we're not going to change H2S and we're not going to change O2. Okay, so if you take away some of the H2O, this is going to get smaller in the numerator. If the numerator gets smaller, that means Q is smaller. So Q is less than K. And if Q is less than K, the reaction goes that way, shifts to the right. And the physical meaning of shifts to the right is that the reaction will go in this direction and you'll start producing more of these and the amounts of these will decrease. Okay, so you're making the change, but it's going to make an additional change. The system itself will make an additional change. Okay, last one, D, addition of S. I'm going to rewrite the expression for K. And then let's write the expression for Q. Sulfur's not in there anywhere. There is no S, right? Because remember, we don't include solids or liquids. So what that tells us is that changing the amount of sulfur has no effect on the equilibrium. It is not going to change the direction of the reaction. There is one exception to that. If you take it out completely, or you didn't have any and you add some. So if you go from zero to something or something to zero, that can affect the equilibrium. But if you have a mole and you take out half a mole, or you have half a mole and you add another half a mole, no effect on equilibrium. So D, no effect because it's a solid. Solids, liquids, no effect. Okay, and there you go. The Chatelier's principle.